check, testing.
Yeah, we're ready.
Hey, Amber, before we get started, there's some glasses that were found back on the dock, so if anybody...
I'm going to be on that side of the stage, so if these are your glasses, come find me at some point.
They were found out here on the dock, so I don't know if you took a walk or... Maybe somebody fell in and left their glasses on there. I don't know.
Well, hello everybody, and welcome to our summer concert series featuring Spittin Image. I'd like to thank our sponsors, the Beavercreek Swimming League and 7-Up. I'm about to turn it over to Spittin Image, so let's give them a big hand.
Hey, thank you. We did a farmer's market over at the old farmer's market. What was that on? Xenia Dayton Road, yes. From 12 to 4 today. Mm-hmm. We got here around, I don't know, 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
And I thought, nobody's going to show up. It's too hot. Look at this. Can we give you a hand? Now listen, how this is going to work, we're going to do 2 songs. And if we end up liking you, we're going to stay, okay? So just, we'll let you know.
I got faith in you.
You do? They look like a pretty good crowd.
Yeah.
I'm not going to bother introducing them until we do the 2 songs. There's no sense in doing that,
yeah,
right?
Exactly.
I don't know which one you are.
It's known that you don't always your path is free to walk. Tend to leave my sleeping bag with a big stash behind your couch. And it's known I'm not jealous, I've got words and bumps. It seems you to try to pull me still alive. I'll put you on the back roads by losing of my memory. How you just jealous on my mind. It's not clinging to the rocks and I'll be planted on the columns now that finally something that somebody said because they how we fit together walk. It's just knowing that the world will not be cursing. I'll forgive when I walk lumps and never drag and burn. That you wait from the back of the spot of my memory. How would you just get on my mind?
Play a little bit for me.
Come making me a bouquet of dog food flowers. Hopefully I'll yet see my baby tonight. Rock me, mama, like where you live. Rock me, mama, in where you feel. Hey, hey, I'm rocking. Well, rock me, mama, like a relay train. Rock me, mama, like a Santa Fe train. Hey, hey, I'm rocking. Running from the coast of a New England life, going to be a visitor in the hometown. Spring band, baby plays the guitar. I pick the banjo now.
and vocals. Would you put your hands together for Blain? Don't. Please don't. Please don't stop. Come here. This guy that looks like me, this is my baby brother. Say aw. By 26 minutes. My twin brother, Brian, on guitar and vocals. Give my twin brother a
thank
hand.
You.
Showing you love him. We're twins, Spittin Image. That's the first question everybody always asks a set of twins is who's the oldest, and we just mentioned that he's the oldest, but 26 minutes, and he reminds me every day, oh, I'm your big brother, pay attention to what I'm saying, oh, I'm 26 minutes older, you gotta listen to what I'm saying. Other day, he walks in the room, and he looks at me and just says, I remember when I was your age, and told me something you did 26 minutes earlier. But anyways, we're going to do a little picking for you. What I do is I lay the bass and drums tracks and the piano tracks down in our studio. We're from Greenville, Ohio. We're just down the road from you guys. We're not far at all. Yeah, we travel all over, but this is our hometown, and our hometown is Greenville, and our home state is Ohio. But we're going to do a little picking for you. I know we got some musicians out there that don't think we're really picking, so we're going to...
Yeah, there's three. What do you want to do? Let's break it up. Do
Bossa Nova. Okay. We'll do a little Bossa Nova piece.
Thank you.
Let's do that. Hey, I like that. I like that whistle. That really makes me feel like I'm at a concert. I like that. Listen, they're filming tonight. If you're with somebody you shouldn't be, this is the time to change when it's pointing the other way. I'm just telling you. That's all I want to make sure. What are we doing, Blain? We're going to do one by the Box Tops, 1967.
Yes.
This is the third number one hit, a little thing called The Letter, okay? If you guys want to dance, for gosh sakes, don't do it. It's very hilly here. You can hurt yourself. You know, you got to look around at the demographics, and our dancing days are over, people. Hey, I'm right with you, man. I'm right with you. This is all for all of us.
Are you ready? You take a drink of water?
I did.
Take a drink of water.
Yeah. I can tell you're thirsty. The Box Top, 1967, The Letter. Father Flanagan and Father Murphy decide to go on vacation. It's been years. They want to get away, a little relaxation. They decide 2 weeks in Hawaii. They're all excited, but they don't want to be recognized as priests. They want to go incognito. So they get some Hawaiian shirts and shorts. They just look like regular tourists. They're down on the beach the first day in Hawaii. Beautiful day out. And they're looking at the beautiful sky and watching the water rushing and picking up seashells. And all of a sudden, this beautiful blonde in a string bikini comes walking down towards him. And as she walks by the priest, she says, "Good morning, fathers," and keeps on walking. And they look at each other like, how did she know we were priests the way we're dressed? So they go to the store and get something even more elaborate. Big old sunglasses, you know, big old floppy hat and a t-shirt, you know, and they go down to the beach again. Same beach, but a different day, but another gorgeous Hawaii, you know, every day's beautiful. So anyways, they're picking up seashells again and wash, water rush in. And here comes that blonde again, gorgeous blonde, about 5'8", real tan, black string bikini, blonde hair, blue eyes. And as she walks by the priest one more time, she says, "Good morning, fathers," and keeps on walking. And Father Flanagan says, "Excuse me, miss, excuse me. You're right, we are priests, and we're proud of it. But how did you know we were priests? I mean, the way we're dressed, how could you possibly know?" She says, "Don't you recognize me? I'm Sister Catherine from the convent." Okay. All right. Yeah, you were so worried about the outcome of that. You know, we know there's family out there and everything. My brother's a professional. Don't do that at home.
No. Dude. There we go.
Time to take a fast train. But only leave the calling, I'm a going home. But baby just wrote me a letter. I don't care how much money I gotta spend. Gotta get back to my baby. But only leave the calling, I'm a going home. But baby just wrote me a letter. I see you feel that ever since you couldn't leave without me no more. It got time to take a fast trip. Lonely days are coming, I'm not going home. Oh, baby, just put me a
a letter. There's something wrong with the audio, and I have no idea how to fix it, but we're just going to keep, the show must go on. Grab that one right there. We're going to do some Waylon and Willie for you. Do you like Waylon Jennings and Willie Nelson? We're going to do a little medley. So I'm going to start with an old Waylon tune, one of my favorites, called Only Daddy That'll Walk the Line, and then Willie Nelson's On the Road Again, and one they did together called Good Hearted Woman. So you guys clap along, sing along. Don't clap too loud because it throws my brother off. He's very sensitive. You just appreciate it. Preacher, Sunday morning, going to give a sermon on human vices, all the terrible things we do to the human body. But he wants to put a different spin on this to get his point across. So before the congregation gets there, he sets up four jars in front of the pulpit. Each jar has a worm in it. The first jar has a worm with whiskey. Second jar has a worm with cigarette smoke. Third jar has a worm with chocolate syrup, but that fourth jar has a worm with fresh topsoil. Now the congregation there, every pew is filled, and he's up there giving that sermon on human vices, and boy, he's pounding his fist and sweating 20, 30, 40 minutes into the sermon. When he's all done with the sermon, he goes down front, takes that first worm out of the whiskey jar, shows the congregation, this worm is dead. The second jar, the second worm with the cigarette smoke, this worm is dead. And that third jar, the one with the worm and the chocolate syrup, this worm is dead. But that fourth jar, the worm with the fresh topsoil, that worm is alive and well. So he says, what message might we get from this? Well, a sweet little lady in the back stands up and says, Preacher, seems to me like if we drink whiskey, smoke cigarettes, and eat chocolate, we won't have worms.
Amen.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I am. By the way, that's not a little baby guitar. That's a five-string mandolin. I want. Folks, would you please sit down? We're trying to do a show. Thank you very much.
Can we start over?
I tell you, this is advertised at 7 o'clock all the time, every show. If we were somebody important, you wouldn't be even allowed in here now at this point in the show. Because everybody's watching you, wanting to see if you're going to fall off the hill there while you're trying to sing. Let's all just stare at them and see what happens. See if the. Oh, isn't that nice? They brought some pizza. And I'm sure there's enough for all of us. Well, isn't that nice?
Okay. Everybody keeps stepping on the door and getting pretty tired of it. We'll pay the club really have a body to let it go to the cook me. He's got a walk, don't wanna hear a squat. Maybe you need to come back home. But ever since you were a little bitty teeny girl, said I wasn't gonna matter before. Now you better do the thing and then you'll find me back at home. Oh, leave that a little walk alive. Turn it off. Oh, yes, it's all. God promised her. Ain't what she's living in. Hey. But she never complains all of the bad times, bad things she's done more. She just talks about the good times they were in all the good times. She loves him in spite of those big words that she don't understand. Well, the teardrops and laughter should pass through this world hand in hand. She's a good-hearted woman in love with a good Simon man.
Celebrate 51 years of picking these things. We got these on our ninth birthday. We got a guitar and mandolin, not these particular ones, but we started playing 51 years ago. At the tender age of 14, we actually started playing in clubs. Our parents had a chaperone us. So we celebrate 46 years of doing this professionally because we played every weekend as kids. And we probably do about 450 shows a year and do about 9-12 shows a week. But I gotta tell you, because I'm standing up here and I'm looking at you guys, and I have never seen anybody more bored than these two kids right here. And I don't know, what were you two thinking bringing these, how old are you, buddy? How old? 8 years old. My gosh, what were they thinking to bring to this? You just feel like you're just about ready to go out of your mind. And how old are you, young lady? 12 years old. I'm so sorry. You understand, I apologize. I don't know what they were thinking. My gosh, can't you take them to the movies or something, you guys? I feel so bad for them. We'll try to make this as quick as possible, guys. I'll tell you what, would you like to be... You played? Did you say she played? You play cello. Could you play the tambourine with us up here on stage? Would you bring your brother? Is that your brother with you? You guys speaking right now? Okay, come on up here. Grab a couple of tents. Yeah, we're going to get them to be a part of this. Because I tell you what, they just look like they're bored out of their minds. And if we could make them a part of this, that'd be pretty cool. Yeah, let's hand that. Okay. Come on up here, right there.
This is the handle.
Yeah. Now listen, guys, we're putting on a show. We got to have smiles. We got to have a good-looking kid here. Let me see your best smile, buddy. Look out there, gal. You keep that going the whole time.
What he said all the time.
Like,
right down front. Oh, yeah, right there in front.
Now listen, if you don't see him smiling, I want you to go like this to him. And then they'll get the picture. And what grade do you start this next year? What grade are you going to be?
Seventh
grade. So that is, that's middle school. So you were the low man on the totem pole in middle school. You were the king in sixth grade, and now you're way down there. Sorry about that. What grade are you going to be in, buddy?
Third
grade. You're excited, aren't you? Do you know who your teacher is?
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to know, do you?
No.
I understand. So what's your favorite subject?
Music.
What was the name of your boyfriend last year? Can't remember? Can't remember. Okay, what are we doing? Oh, we're doing a little rockabilly music.
Rockabilly.
You know, the Stray Cats got back together this year. In fact, they started a tour about a month ago in Vegas. But anyways, we're going to do a little medley of some of those great songs by the Stray Cats.
Right, I've got OCD. I need you right here in the middle. It's going to bug me if that don't happen. Right there. Oh, I'm going to go crazy with it.
Are you ready, Blake?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Saturday night, had my head bowed out of my that looks so right. Well, now I'm 15, gotta get your material out. I do what I got for me, and all right.
Show just as fast as possible. Big hand, let that applause take them all the way back to their seats there. I thought the whistle was coming from one of those guys, and it's you. That was, do that again. Let me see you do that. Do that. Just right now. Do that whistle. My second ex-wife could do that. Same thing, too. And that brings back a lot of good memories. Let's do that Blake Shelton song. Let's do that. She never did that. We're going to do a Blake Shelton song for you right now. Oh my gosh. Are we having fun? Yeah. Thank you for taking the time to come out here. I appreciate this. Okay. Get that thing off. Is there any fish in that big old net up there? Did you catch anything? Well, you were playing on something, weren't you? We're disappointed. Now listen, there's no alcohol allowed on the park. They've heard our show before, and I love them, but they can't hear our show without alcohol, and I understand that. But we sound better when you're drinking. Well, they know that. Okay. I don't wanna take off, baby.
couple little closer, couple little closer, couple little closer. Girl, the way you look tonight, my eyes are the only place I wouldn't want to take off. Couple little closer, couple little closer, couple little closer. Love the way you look tonight, my eyes are the only place I wouldn't want to take off. Some amazing things, but my eyes ain't seen nothing quite like you. Hey baby, come a little closer, come a little closer, come a little closer. Girl, the way you look tonight, my eyes are the only thing I wanna take off. Come a little closer, come a little closer, come a little closer. Love the way you look tonight, my eyes are the only thing. Come a little closer, come a little closer, come a little closer. Love the way you look tonight. My eyes are the only thing I don't want to take off.
I know, but I didn't have a...
This is not a race, so don't try to finish before me.
I'm on Facebook.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Meet in college, become best friends all through their college years. But when these guys graduate college and get jobs, they move to different points of the country, don't see each other for 30 years. Their first college reunion, they're all in their 50s, and they want to get away, just away from everybody else. That's the good old days. Where do you want to go? One guy said, let's go to Mally's. They said, what do you want to go to Mally's for? He said, the waitresses are young and beautiful, the food's great, the drinks are great. They go and they have a super time. Then 10 years passes, their next college reunion, now they're all in their early 60s, and they want to get together, just the four of them, away from the crowd, just like the good old days. You got a bunch of stuff to talk about. Where do you want to go? One guy says, I want to go to Mally's. What do you want to go to Mally's for? They have senior discounts on the food. They go and they have a super time, but then another 10 years passes. Now they're all in their early 70s, and oh, they got so much to share and talk about. And come on, guys, let's just get away, the four of us. Where do you want to go? One guy says, let's go to Mally's. We will go to Mally's for. They have five handicapped parking spaces. They get right in the front row. There's a ramp up to the door. The restrooms are handicapped facilitated. They have a super time. But you're right, another 10 years passes. Now they're all in their early 80s, and they got a lifetime of stories and pictures to share. Where do you want to go, guys? Just the four of us, like the good old days. Where do you want to go? One guy says, hey, let's go to Mally's. What do you want to go to Mally's for? We've never been there. $1965,
California. Trailer is for sale, boy. Dreams needs to make 50 cents. No bumbo, no bag. Ain't got no cigarettes. I've been 2 hours of pushing brew. Buys an 8x12 4-bit brew. I've been making the beans by no means. King of the road. Third box car in my train. Destination Bayard, Maine. Old worn out suit and shoes. I don't think of union dues. I want the old stogies I have found. Sure, but not too big around. I'm a man of me by no means. King of the road. I know every engineer on every train.
Medley for you right now, and it's going to start out with Fox on the Run, rolling in my sweet baby's arms. I think he's going to do about 16 bars of maybe a little bit more than that of Foggy Mountain Breakdown, and then we'll do, you can't do a bluegrass medley without doing Rocky Top, so that's going to be in there too. So we're doing a little bluegrass for you, and if we got some two-steppers out there, please be careful.
Yeah, till the train.
the exact reason why we don't allow alcohol in the park. This is the reason, right there. Somebody could have got hurt. Now everybody's fine, but that's... Let's do that. We're gonna do some...
That was good.
That was... No,
big hand.
That was great. So, is that one yours? The one... That's yours. You claim it, they claim that one, okay. Because he seemed to get pepped up a little bit more when you whistled. I thought maybe that was his, you know, like the dog, you know, that's the, you know, makes you, okay. Anyways, we're gonna do a little thing called Good Lovin' by the Rascals. Lady, would you please sit down? We're trying to do a show here thing. Okay.
One, two, three, good love. Good love, good love. I was feeling so bad, so I had my family doctor do what I had. And I said, doctor, doctor, Mr. MD, doctor, can you tell me what's ailing me, doctor? Yeah, all you need. All right. Feel that day. Good love. Feel good love. Good love. All I need is love. Good love. Good love. Good love. I was feeling so bad, so I had my family doctor do what I had. And I said, doctor, doctor, Mr. MD, doctor, can you tell me what's ailing me, doctor? And he said, yeah, 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 all you need.
But these gals are from the Women's Reformatory in Marysville, Ohio. And this is the warden. I'm proud to be a part of this. There is a little release program because these guys have been doing such a good job and they've been doing real good. And so they let them out for the weekend. And warden, I appreciate this. Be responsible for this. And this is the Apple Sisters. We got CD, Corey, Carmel, and Rotten. And they used to rob banks in northeastern Ohio for years, and she probably saw in the papers. It was more in the papers up north. But anyways, and Warden, everything seems to be going good. Now, this is the last day of the weekend. Is everything okay?
So far.
So far, so good.
Now, I noticed you were taking videos. Is that a live cam back to the reformatory?
Yes.
Okay, so they can see what's going on. And I'm really, are they really allowed to be drinking, though? Are they allowed to do that? Huh?
That's their
Kool-Aid. Now, Warren, did you approve the Kool-Aid? Did you test it yet?
Yes.
Okay. And I feel very comfortable with this. I do. But they are going straight back, right? Okay.
Sort of.
Yeah, well, I do. Hey, do we have any Johnny Cash fans out there?
Yeah! Okay.
Hello? My name is Johnny
the one person that said no, where are you at, honey? It's who I think it was. We were talking earlier, and she thought Johnny Cash was a pay toilet. She doesn't know nothing about Johnny Cash. We're going to do a medley of Johnny Cash songs. The first song in this medley is a little thing called Folsom Prison Blues. And the thing about Folsom Prison Blues is whether you like country or not, or whether you like rock and roll, whatever, everybody knows this song. Everybody recognizes the intro. The intro goes like this. Let me pick this. Now, I had the chance to hear Johnny Cash live one time. This has probably been about 37 years ago, a little town in West Virginia. And it was a little club, and there probably wasn't more than 30 people in that club. Johnny was sitting the way in the back, and the band was playing for a good hour. Finally, he stood up and walked towards the bandstand, and a hush fell over the room. He walked up there and picked off that intro, and I mean, those 30 people, and that's all it was 30 people. They sounded like 1,000 people. I couldn't believe the excitement. I could not believe the energy out there. I could not believe it. In all these years that I've been in this business and all the audiences we played in front of, I always wondered what it felt like to have that kind of energy and excitement out there in the audience for me. I wonder if you'd all do a favor for me. I know I'm asking an awful lot, but if you guys could sound like 2,000 people, because we got way more than 30 people out there, I want you to pretend that I'm Johnny Cash. Now look, I know I'm not Johnny Cash. I know that. I know that. I want you to pretend that I'm Johnny Cash. I want you to pretend this is my semi-beautiful wife, June Carter, over here. And I'm going to pick this thing off, and I want you to sound like 2,000 people. Can you do that for me? Can you do that? That night, men were crying, women were tossing babies in the air. It was unbelievable. Lady, would you please sit down? We're trying to do a show. I'm excited about this.
It's a great idea.
They could do it.
You think? You think they'll do it?
This would be great. Well, you're gonna sleep good tonight, aren't you?
Well, if they do it.
Are you gonna pretend this wife?
What? Am I gonna be? I gotta ask. This sounds like a very important question. I shouldn't do that.
He's excited to be your wife.
I don't think he is.
He said, let's do that. He
said
that's a good idea. He said that was a good idea.
Lady, you trying to start something? We have fights on our own without you helping at all. I'm telling you right now. We don't need you to help us fight.
I think he likes to be your wife.
Okay.
Thank you.
She's trying to be funny, Blaine. Come on. She's taking our audience right out of my hands, I'll tell you what. Okay, here we go. Man, it's just what she wanted. Brian, aren't you happy? Brian. You know, 46 years ago, when I was just a kid, that would have thrilled me to death. Took my breath away. 46 years later, 60 years old, the only thing I could see was the one person decide not to do anything at all. Just sit there and not do a thing. Mike, Michael, you broke my heart. I've been married 3 times, divorced 3 times, and you broke my heart. Is there a reason why you did not participate? I was wearing my heart on my sleeve. I was really, really just expressing my deepest, darkest...
I don't know that song.
But that's okay. I just said that I picked that thing off, pretend I'm Johnny Cash, and just clap. You could have just it doesn't matter if you don't know who Johnny Cash is. It makes no difference. Do you feel bad at all being the only person didn't, and everybody else, you were fantastic. I thank you so much. Now, Michael, I'm going to do this one more time, and I would appreciate it if you would please just give a little bit of something back. Thank you. That was the least you could do. I appreciate that. Okay, I gotta get back here before he forgets what he's supposed to do.
Hurry, Brian, don't fall.
Well, I don't
hurry.
I don't want to fall. Hurry, don't fall. Okay, you know, and I tell you what, if I remember right, Johnny Cash just maybe had 1 or 2 notes out. The rest of you did great.
You're wonderful.
Keep it up.
the train comes, they move around. I'm soon the sunshine, so I go away. I'm not the folks in prison, I'll be drinking home. When I hear that whistle blow, I'll never say it.
Had on there. How many years were you in Air Force, Michael?
27.
27 years. You know what we're going to do? We're going to do a medley of all five anthems of all the branches, and it's going to be the Coast Guard, the Air Force, the Army, the Navy, and the Marine Corps. How many veterans do we have out? Let's just, by a show of hands, how many veterans do we have out? Beautiful. Look at that. And I know we've got some gals out there that maybe their spouses are no longer with us in the service. Now, we're going to do all five branches. He'll holler them out. So when we get to your particular one, I want you to stand up and acknowledge that particular one. The show of the Army. Let's see the Army out there.
Ooh, wow.
Look at that. There we go.
All right.
How about the Navy? How about the Air Force? We got any Marines out there? Our dad was in the Marine Corps, and an older brother was in the Marine Corps. And what about the Coast Guard? We can't forget the Coast Guard. And we don't often get Coast Guard out there, but we're going to do that also, of course. And that's, even though my dad was in the Marines, the Coast Guard's the closest to my heart because my ex-wife was in the Coast Guards. Yes, she was.
She was not.
Yeah. Yes, she was. Which one? Tammy. The third one, yeah. You're kidding. I found out by accident she was in the Coast Guard. I'll tell you how it happened. It's kind of cute. But Blain and I were out west for 16 weeks just picking in the green and having a good time. We're gone for 16 weeks. Came back, had 3 days off. The second day I was home, the phone rang, and my wife at the time answered the phone. I picked up the extension, and I heard some guy ask her if she was if the coast was clear. And that's how I found out. Anyways, thank you so much for coming out. I sure do appreciate it. We both do very much. We're going to close with this. Hey, if you want to take us home, we've got CDs over here, DVDs. Also, grab a business card. They're only $10. It's got our website on there, our full schedule, and we'd love to see you in another show. A lot of you we would. Some of you we're not. And the girls going straight back to the reformatory tonight, and you guys,
they can help us slow it up first. Yeah.
Thank you. I tell you what, we're going to give the warden a break. We'll take the girls back, and we're going to have them help us load up, and we'll give them something to eat, and then we'll get them back to America. I know right where Marysville is at. We'll get them right there. And you go on home and don't worry about a thing. Till Monday morning. When you've lost your job. Okay. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah.
Thank you.
Thank you.